All right, I'm over at Panasonic with Matt Frazier, and we are looking at encased in glass over here, Lumix full frame. Tell me all about it.
Yeah, it's like Fort Knox right now. We've got it under we've got it under heavy protection here. So what we're showing is the S1R, which is our planned full frame camera, which should be coming out sometime in the spring. Obviously, the things that have already been sort of talked about with the camera. This is our 47 megapixel version. We'll also have an S1 that'll be a 24 megapixel version. Things that carry over from Micro Four Thirds that people will enjoy are the dual IS system. So it has the 5-axis in-body stabilization that we've developed for the G series, and then the dual system works with our lenses as well. We've announced 4K 60 for the cameras also. So some of the first cameras, I think they are the first cameras in full frame that can do 4K 60p.
Nice. So we've got over here a 50 millimeter and a 24-105. Are there any other lenses that are going to be released sort of at launch, or is that sort of also under lock and key?
So we've announced three lenses. So the 50 will be an f1.4, and it's going to be a very special lens if you take a look at it, for sure, because it's a pretty big 50. You're going to have a 24-105. We're trying to keep some secrets, so you'll hear f-stops a little later on that. And then there's going to be a 70-200. Again, f-stop will be announced a little bit later. We plan to have 10 lenses out sometime in 2020 is what our plan is. But on top of that, this uses the L-mount. So all you Leica shooters out there, you're going to love this. That means that your Leica SL lenses will work on this camera body. And obviously, our lenses are going to work on the Leica SL. And Sigma has partnered with us also. So we're all licensees of this. Sigma has said they're going to have 14 lenses available for the system sometime in 2020. And then Leica already has, I believe, 7 or 8 lenses. And they've said they should plan on having about 10 lenses by 2020. So if you look at 2020 and think maybe a little early, hopefully, in 2020, that means you're going to have over 33 lenses for the system within a very short period of time.
Now, a lot of people were concerned that with everyone going full frame, that Panasonic is not going to support their old Micro Four Thirds system going forward, because it seems like full frame is where the money's at. But from what I understand, that's not the case, and we've got a lens we want to look at in just a little bit.
Yeah, so I think I understand that concern a little bit, but the reality is every major manufacturer typically supports two systems. They support a full frame system and they support a crop frame system. So we are looking at it in the same perspective. You know, Micro Four Thirds and G series is for portability, compact, lightweight production. Full frame gives you the added advantages of better low light sensitivity and a little more creative control over depth of field because of the larger sensor. So we obviously saw a market need for full frame, and we also see a market frame for Micro Four Thirds. But on top of that, I don't think people realize how many pro bodies Panasonic actually builds. When you look at the GH5, the GH5S, and the G9, all of those would be pro grade bodies. You know, the G9, it can do 60 frame per second burst and 20 frame per second burst with continuous autofocus, both those in RAW. And they can do 50 images per RAW burst before you have to empty a buffer. So those are clearly pro bodies. Well, that's three crop bodies. These are designed to be pro bodies as well. So we're not quoting burst rates or anything else, but if you just look at the history of what we've done in our pro bodies in the G9, the GH5 and GH5S, and you can imagine where we're going with the S1 and S1R, you can see that it's going to be a very complete set of professional photography tools. For professionals who covet lightweight and compact bodies, that's where the G series lives. For professionals who need full frame, that's where the S series is going to live.
All right, so there's going to be lots of new lenses available for the full frames. Now, this might be looking a little forward into the future, but is there any plans to adapt those full frame lenses to the Micro Four Thirds bodies, just because people might be a fan of the Lumix system and they still want to use their older bodies and they want to take advantage of the optics of these new lenses? Is there anything in the pipeline for that?
Until we know more about the system, our engineers haven't said anything yet as to compatibilities one way or the other. But I will say that for the G series bodies, we've introduced a new lens that is planned to be out sometime next year. And that is it's a lens I'm really excited about, because it's a focal length that I would use a lot. It covers from 10 millimeters to 25, so full frame equivalent, that's going to be a 20 to 50. And it's an f1.7 across the entire focal length. So it's right now the world's fastest zoom lens.
Do you have one of those hanging around?
Yeah, I keep one in my back pocket. You know, I'm joking. We have it actually. Yeah, why don't we go and do that now?
All right, we made it over to the coveted 10 to 25. This is an f1.7 lens. So this is going to be a really great lens to pair up with your GH cameras, GH5, GH5S. perfect video focal range, and this is a 20 to 50 35 millimeter equivalent range, right?
Right, and you could put on a GM5 if you wanted to. You might not be able.
Did I say GM5? I've got so many.
I'm totally joking. You said GH. We're good.
I knew it.
Yeah. So what we're doing here is we're really trying to give you a full frame look with a Micro Four Thirds sensor. So when you think about this is an f1.7 constant aperture, which gives you roughly an f3.4 equivalent depth of field. So it's really that nice shallow depth of field you'd get on a 24 to 70 with a full frame, but it's wider. So you start with that nice 20 millimeter angle of view. I think there's going to be a lot of people who do like mixed photography, anywhere from architectural and street to, you know, landscape work, that are going to really like this lens. And then obviously for video shooters, this is like a dream focal length for a lot of their use. And then that fast aperture is amazing on it. And then with the improvements we just announced on the autofocus system, cameras like the G9 and the GH5S with that body tracking we have, it's amazing the improvements we made to the video autofocus on them. I've done a lot of testing with it. This is the first time I can really come out and say that I've totally blown away by the autofocus. So having autofocus functionality in this camera lens is going to really be a pretty significant game changer for Micro Four Thirds users who are shooting video.
This is one of the largest lens, if not the, I guess it's the biggest in terms of width, as far as I've seen in Micro Four Thirds lenses. Now, you, of course, Panasonic's going to be supporting the Micro Four Thirds system going forward. Are we going to see more lenses like this with more bigger optical elements?
That's difficult to say. I think the market, it's important to understand that you as consumers ultimately decide what Panasonic is going to do by the dollar that's spent. You know, a lens that is like this, if the market decides it's something they want and they buy a reasonable quantity of it, we're going to investigate more fast optics for that segment. If it's not popular, then we're going to look at other segments to be able to exploit, right? That's the, ultimately, we don't run, this isn't a not-for-profit. You know, we have to make a profit. But I am super hopeful that this is going to be an incredibly popular lens. And if it's very popular, it would give us hope for other options that would be like it. But we're always going to look at ways to mix and match optics within Micro Four Thirds. You know, it's a balancing act, right? We're trying to go for a lightweight, compact system. But then more and more professional shooters are moving into our system, and they're wanting to occasionally get the look of their full-frame camera, and that's where a lens like this is useful. But then if for portability, you may choose to use a 12 to 35 f/2.8, or what we just did recently, which is the 12 to 60 f/2.8 to f/4, or a 50 to 200 f/2.8 to f/4, or an 8 to 18 f/2.8 to f/4. The point is, we want to have lots of different options for different uses and different sizes, and this gives us now a look that's closer to a full frame lens.
Well, there's definitely no shortage of options for whether you're a crop shooter or whether you're a full frame shooter, because that will be coming soon. There's going to be loads of lenses available for that. So Panasonic is really doing the Lord's work, giving us lots of options to choose from. So as photographers, we couldn't be happier.
Well, as a manufacturer, just keep giving us feedback. If we feel like it's something that's worth our while to add, or more importantly, is going to help you as a creative, if we hear enough about it, we're happy to expect it, consider it, and invest the time.
Any idea on a launch date for the full frame?
We know sometime in spring is what we've been told.
Okay. All right. So, and what about this lens here?
They haven't really given us a date yet, so I couldn't really tell you. I promise you, if we had a date, I would even try to hint at it here, but we just don't know anything at this time.
Well, it looks like it's pretty much complete, so hopefully we'll be seeing one soon at Cometa Camera.